Hello and welcome to another pandemically erotic episode of A Crept from the 80s. This is a short episode. This is going to be another haul video, gifted video. A few online friends and extended fans and extended family and my wife got me a few things, and I want to show off some stuff that recently came in the past couple, I guess past month or so. And I do want to say thank you to the new subscribers. And if you like what you watch, if you like what you see on the video, on the channel, please subscribe, like, let us know, comment, talk to us, tell your friends who are also 80s obsessed and people in their 40s who still act like they're in their teens, like me. And I'm going to quench my thirst as I talk to you with a juicy juice orange tangerine, which is basically Ecto Cooler, guys. This is a Fright Rag shirt, new Fright Rags Ghostbusters shirt. Go check out FrightRags.com, Fright-Rags.com. But this is basically Ecto Cooler. It tastes just like Ecto Cooler, a little less sweet than Ecto Cooler, but it is indeed Ecto Cooler. I also really quick want to talk about getting to 900 subscribers, and that is finally 900 is when we are going to do the next big live show, and we are giving two things away. And in order to possibly win these two things, all you got to do is tell your friends, promote this channel, subscribe, like, comment on the videos, and two lucky winners are gonna get two items. And one of the items, as we've talked about before, is the Masters of the Universe Super 7 Merman, Filmation style, Super 7 Masters of the Universe 2.0. And the newly released Real Ghostbusters, the re-release, retro release of the Kenner Real Ghostbusters 1986 figures. This is the Stay Puft Marshmallow Man, still in the box. And we are going to be giving away this as well to a lucky subscriber and commenter and promoter of the channel. So please do. Once we hit that 900, we will do a live show and we will do the giveaways on that show. While we're on the topic of who you gonna call, I did manage to get those Real Ghostbusters re-releases. So here is Slimer, a green ghost, in the packaging. Very slight differences from the original Kenner 1986 line, but here they are. And then we got Ray, and I have my originals over there, that I was luckily... My originals were ruined by my son when he was littler, because I let him play with them. Here's Winston. But I was lucky enough to be gifted the originals again with their proton packs by Sean Pinkerton, who is a friend and fan of the channel and the movies that I do. And Peter. And Stay Puft, who I just showed. This is my Stay Puft. So I got all of those, and they will stay in the packages and be displayed, since I already have them out of the package.
I got this and a couple other Fright Rags things recently, thanks to Ben and Tansky.
I also got this company, Gutter Garbs, who also does really rad horror t-shirts. They had a pretty great sale weeks ago, and we had to jump on that sale, so I got a Return of the Living Dead 2 t-shirt, a Slumber Party Massacre 2 t-shirt, a shopping mall with the original title Killbots,
And Ghoulies 2, which is the best Ghoulies film. But Ghoulies 3, Ghoulies Go to College, is also pretty fun. Okay, I also picked up... Now, I would say the last year I have recently gotten into wrestling again. And I got in a very different way because I wanted to sort of reacquaint myself with the wrestling world, because I am an 80s wrestling fan and I love the cheese and the over-the-topness and the theatrics and all that stuff. And you can find that out on our wrestling episode down below. But I wanted people to root for, and I didn't know anybody in the modern day, so I started watching like those reality shows like Total Divas and those types of shows, and I really ended up liking the Bella Twins for all different levels. So I became a fan of the Bella Twins, and I recently got their book, so I am excited to read this book. Check that out, you know? I also recently got the NECA, oh no, these are the Funko, these are the Dark Crystal action figures. I have Deet and Hup up there on the walls, and this is Ogra and the Hunter Skeksis. I still need to get Rianne and the Silk Spitter. And then I will have the initial first line of these Dark Crystal Age of Resistance toys. I'm a giant fan of the original movie. My grandmother took me to see it when it opened in theaters. She hated it. I loved it. I'm a big Jim Henson Muppet fan. If you know my channel, you know my love of the Muppets. And I will be doing a Muppet-centric episode. So I guess along those lines, for Father's Day, my wife got me the Inside the Epic Return to Thra, the Dark Crystal Age of Resistance making of book, which I can't wait to get into. And she also got me this really rad 80s style retro Madrin boombox. It's got all the bells and whistles that you would have in the 80s. But also updated with, you know, SD slots and USBs and MP3s and Bluetooths. And you can also transfer your tapes into MP3s and all that good stuff. And the sound is delicious. I like this company. This is the company that also our record player is downstairs. But she got me this to... you know, add to my magically rad 80s room. And then Uber fan and friend Sean Pickerton randomly sent me stuff off my wish list. I have a couple Amazon wish lists, and every now and again he just randomly sends me stuff from it, which is amazing and humbling, and I thank you, thank you, thank you. So I wanted a HDMI AV converter so that I could watch a lot of my VHS stuff on my my projector and 120-inch screen downstairs. So I got that. I'm also a huge Godzilla fan, so he got me the double feature of Godzilla GMK and Godzilla Against Mechagodzilla, which is on my list. Hot Shots Part 2 on Blu-ray. Is on my list. A Hanna-Barbera classic. I grew up with these guys. The Underwater Smurfs. The Snorks. Finally, a legit DVD of one of my favorite sequels, Meatballs 2. I love it. If you're a fan of my film Stoinky Beach, then you're a fan of Meatballs 2. And the volume one, I have the volume two, but the volume one of Denver, The Last Dinosaur, the 1988 classic cartoon, which I also enjoy. So thank you, Sean, so much for that. And now we'll get into some of these other things. These were cheap, so I picked them up. I when this came out, I didn't grab it, but I did see it in theaters. So this is It Chapter 2. It was pretty cheap on Blu-ray, so picked it up. This was cool, and I do have the slipcover, but I'm selling the slipcover because I'm not a big fan of slipcovers at all. But the Scream Factory My Bloody Valentine I found in a Target just sitting on a pile of Stranger Things Blu-rays, and this was $9. So this was, hell yeah, I was going to pick it up. I love this movie, and I love the remake. I already have this movie, but I wanted to get the 3D version because I love home 3D. It is so awesome, and especially on the 120-inch screen and the projector and everything, it's just mind-blowing, and I have top-of-the-line shit. Well, top-of-the-line that I would say top-of-the-line. You can get way better shit, but my stuff is perfect for the room, and I love the 3D, so I got Aquaman 3D. Continuing the Andy Sedaris collection Blu-rays, which are from Mill Creek, and they are doing fantastic restorations of these movies. I got the Dallas Connection and Enemy Gold, and we just need two more, which are coming out, which is Day of the Warrior and Return to Savage Beach. And then I'll have the Andy Sedaris collection on Blu-ray. Crazy! I am shocked that it took me this long to finally get this movie on Blu-ray, and it has been sitting in my wish list forever, but UHF on Blu-ray. I love this movie. I love Weird Al. Grew up with this guy. I remember seeing the trailer for this movie for the first time when Ghostbusters 2 opened at our drive-in, and it was my second time seeing Ghostbusters 2. And the first time I had any inclination that UHF was coming out was the trailer in front of Ghostbusters 2. And I was so, so jazzed, excited. This is my favorite John Hughes movie, so I had to upgrade and get all these dope special features and the 4K restoration and all that good stuff. This is the Arrow release of 16 Candles. I can't wait to dip into this. They always do a fantastic job, so I had to pick this up. Finally, I am all done now. Thanks to this, I finally have every season of Different Strokes. This is the final season of Different Strokes, the 8th season, and it is now in my collection, thankfully. Different Strokes. This was interesting. This was on sale, so I got it, and season 3 was not on sale. But now it is again, so I gotta go back and try to get season 3, which is also on my wish list. But Punky Brewster, I love this show. Season 4, the last season, I just gotta get season 3, and I'll have all of them. What's cool about this release also is pretty much you're getting the first season of It's Punky Brewster, the 1985 cartoon show that is like laid out on all 4 seasons of the releases. You can get pretty much the first season of the cartoon show. And the first and second seasons of Mr. Belvedere. Love this show. Freaks on the Channel. Never met it before. So that is my recent haul video. That is some dope stuff that I recently got. Again, I want to thank Sean. Oh! I also got this. This was $13 at Walmart, and the only reason I hadn't gotten it yet was because I wasn't gonna pay $50. So I got Jabba's Palace, $13 clearance, and it is open and it is over there. And you're also gonna get a room tour of the, because I updated the 80s room a bit, so you're gonna get that at the end of this video. I want to thank you again for joining me here on It Crept from the 80s, and I hope you've been enjoying all of the episodes. Please, if you like what you're seeing, please subscribe. Give us a like and comment with us. Talk with us. Tell us your 80s memories. And yeah, spread the word, please. Like I said, 900 subscribers, and we're doing the live show and finally giving away those toys, those rad toys. And if you're a fan of my movies, Low Budget Pictures, Warlock Home Video, I am doing a deal right now. You can get 12 of my films on 7 Blu-rays for only $80 shipped. And if you want to start collecting any of my, or finish your collection of LBP or Warlock Chris Seaver films, you better hurry fast, because I am not going to be doing DVDs at all very soon. I'm going to discontinue those, and we'll be doing some extra special Blu-ray releases down the road. But yeah, the DVDs are going away for good. So yeah, so thank you again. And we got some new episodes coming up with Chris Tansky and Bobby Heckman and lots of stuff and Casey Bauker, and it's all gonna happen again. We're still in that pandemic and things are crazy, crusty, wet and wild. And we just gotta keep partying on and stay safe and wear those masks and social distance, wash your hands and be safe, everybody. Be excellent to each other, as Bill and Ted would say. And we'll see you on another erotic episode of A Crept from the 80s. So thanks, everyone. All right, so we are doing the upgraded 80s room tour. Here we are. Now what I did was, I was able to put up a bunch more posters that I had, and put up the faux wood paneling like I had in my two bedrooms growing up in the 80s. And I think it looks pretty great. I moved some toys around. So go over here, 80s stuff, 80s magazines, 80s books, coloring books. Cereal boxes of delicious cereals I partook in. Still need Gator and Firecracker and the Bullet, and that is it for my mask collection. That's it. That's all I need. He-Man. I need lots of He-Man still. That is the classics. There's some originals and the 8-bit zombie Thrasher. First toy love growing up, probably 1981. I was 4 years old, and the Kenner Star Wars line was the toy of choice. That's my original Grizzlor. Sevens. I am anxiously awaiting for Masters of the Universe Origins to hit, hopefully in the next month or two. There's already scalpers online that are destroying us fans and charging double, triple for the Origins that Walmart is already letting out online. Ghostbusters, another beloved Kenner line. Be sure to check out the Ghostbusters video that I just recently put up. More Star Wars. He-Man.
to cereal, another delicious cereal. My original, still my original Millennium Falcon. Some carded figs up there. Bionic 6, Return of the Jedi. My beautiful cat, the snow leopard herself, Freya. And that is the updated Hades room. Huzzah! Huzzah! Huzzah!